Hello again, here we will use a module that is called ReportLab to create a PDF like this one. We will start by creating the title, then the subtitle, draw this line, create this text, and finally insert this picture. The first step is installing ReportLab. Pip install ReportLab. Hit enter. ReportLab is successfully installed. We can do our code. Close the terminal. In the code, the first step is create a PDF file, and for that we need to import canvas from ReportLab. So from reportlab.pdfgen import canvas. Now we can create our PDF. PDF is equals to canvas.canvas with uppercase, and we need to provide a file name for this, okay? I have already some resources. If we go up here, the first one is the file name, then we have the document title, the title for PDF, subtitle, text lines that we will write, and the path for the image. Copy this file name, we go down, we paste here the file name. The next step is save the file, so pdf.save. Let's see if this is working. We open here to see if any file appears, and we open the terminal, and let me clear this. Py PDF example.py, hit enter, and a new document was created here. Let me go to the folder and open this in the browser. As you can see, is an empty file. Now we can start doing things. For example, you see here we have untitled. Let's set a title to this document. We go to Visual Studio Code and we type pdf.setTitle, and we provide the document title. Let's see if this is working. We open the terminal, run the program again, and we go to the browser and refresh the document. And now we have here document title. Okay, we are ready to do the code for the file. Let me close the terminal. Let me put the PDF save at the end of everything. Okay, I go down, and here after the image, that is the last exercise, I put here the PDF.save. Okay, let's go to the first exercise, that is inserting the title. Okay, pdf.drawstring, and here we need to provide a position for x and y. Because we don't know the coordinates, we will type 0 and 0. Then we pass the title. And this is the result. Okay, we have the title, what we wrote in the end of the file. Okay, here. To help us with the coordinates, I have already a function in the top of this file that is called drawMyRuler. It will receive the PDF and it will draw, for example, here, it will draw x100 for the position x equals to 100, and here is for x equals to 500. Okay, for the y coordinate is the same thing. We have y100 to y800. Okay, so we will call this function and we will see in the document the coordinates. We save the file and the result was this. Now we have here the coordinates and we want to put the title more or less in this position. Here we change the coordinates to be 274x, 774y. As you can see, we have the title more or less in the middle, okay? Now let's add some style to this. Let's put this line of code before everything here. And first, let's see the fonts that we can use. I copy and paste here some code that I already have, and here I am asking for the available fonts and printing it in the console. I open the terminal and let's run, and we have the available fonts here. But for the title, we will not use these fonts, one of these fonts. I downloaded a free font from a website that is this one, okay? And we will apply this one to our document. We need to register a new font from reportlab.pdfbase.truetypefonts. We want to import truetypefonts font. Also, from reportlab.pdfbase, we want to import PDF metrics. Let's go a little down, and now we can start registering our new font. PDF metrics.registerFont. We provide a true type font ABC, for example, and it comes from the file. Let's go to the folder. Let me copy the name of the file. Go back to the code and paste here the name of the file. Now we can type pdf.setFontABC and let's give it a size of 36. And this is the result. We have the new font, but the title moved, okay? So we want to move the title a little for this position. It will start more or less here, okay? So instead of using the drawString, we can use another function that is drawCenteredString. As you can see, the title moved, but is not in the center. The idea of drawCenteredString is we give x and y position of the middle, and it calculates the space that it must go back. So we want to put here in the x300, and it will calculate the values to be here in the center. Okay, we apply here instead of 200, it will be 300, and our title is more or less in the middle. Okay, now let's draw the subtitle. PDF draw centered string at 290 and 720, and we provide the subtitle. Also, we need to set the font, because if we not change the font, it will continue with the previous font. PDF dot set font, we will use this font and a size of 24. Also, we can set the color of the text. PDF dot set fill color RGB for red, green and blue. Red is 0, green is 02, and the value for blue is 255, the maximum. It will be blue text, okay? And this is the result. We have here the largest carnivorous marsupial. Now let's draw a line, pdf.line, and now we need to provide the coordinates x and y for the begin of the line. It will be 34 x, 710 for y. We need to provide a x and y coordinate for the end of the line, 550 for x, 710 for y, okay? As you can guess, this will be a horizontal line, because we have a y position that is fixed, okay? The start y coordinate is equals to the end y coordinate, okay? Our document have a horizontal line here. Now let's draw text that is equals to pdf.beginText. We type x and y coordinates, 40 and 680. Also, we give it a font and a size. We give a color with text.setFillColor. This is a new method, and we provide the color red. For this to work, we need to import colors from reportlab.lib. Now we want to append the lines of text to this object. So for each line in text lines, our variable with the content, we want to text.textLine, and we provide the line. Okay. After this, we type pdf.drawText and we provide the text. And now we have here our text. Let's do the final part, that is draw an image. PDF draw inline image. We provide the image path and the x and y coordinates. We open the terminal and we run this. We go to the document, refresh this, and now we have here our Tasmanian Devil. This is the end. You can download the source code, the link is in the description. If you find this video helpful, please give it a like, it will help me. And as always, thank you for watching.